All right. The last candidate that we'll be interviewing today is Javier Lozano. Welcome to the stage, Javier.
Hey, thank you for having so much. It's great to be here for the second time. So my apologies for crashing earlier.
Oh, no, we weren't live yet.
Oh, so perfect.
No crashing.
sorry, Jamie, for crashing the interview.
No, that's the neat thing about StreamYard. We have a backstage. So even if you join early, we didn't plop you on early. So no worries.
I was going to blame it on Jeff Fritz because he sent me an email and I was like, oh my gosh, I'm late. I got to jump, click on the link.
It's always good to blame Jeff.
There's a full Pavlonian response. That's what it was, based on links.
So Javier, tell us why you're running for the .NET Foundation.
Great. Yeah. So first of all, my name is Javier Lozano. And the reason why I'm running for the .NET Foundation is because I think we could do better from advocacy and marketing of the current .NET projects that we have. So what I mean by that is that, sure, we have a GitHub repo that has documentation. We have a wiki that may have documentation, but that's literally of how. Here's how you turn the widget, turn it on, turn it off. Here's how you do it, but not necessarily why I should use it, right? And there is some resource when it comes to time from being an open source developer, which I have been in the past, and that you only have either A, I work on feature X, or I answer issue, or I come up with documentation, or I do a tutorial, or I do all these different things, and it just gets difficult. So if we were to provide a way for not necessarily the actual author, but other people who are trying to work their way into the project to say, hey, let's do a 20-minute or 30-minute, here's how you do XYZ and why it's good to do XYZ. Right. So it's more of a marketing thing. You know, we have really smart people contributing to these projects. So we don't need more bits. We need more what's and how's, right? Yeah. To be able to do those things. And I think up to this point, I view that the .NET Foundation is different cycles, right? So we've gone through where we have the first board that was essentially last year and a half, where the board has been working on this and they create a good foundation for what we have right now. So now let's try to move things forward, right? Let's try another layer. Not saying that they did anything, but it's just like, okay, now let's build upon that and upon that and upon that. Because that's essentially what the foundation is. It's supposed to outlast any member, right, as you go along. So I have different ideas that we could try. And all of these are based on some of the work that we've done with a project that I run with the foundation, the .NET Conf, which is a virtual conference for .NET. So
that's very neat. So .NET Conf is new then?
.NET Conf is actually, it depends on where you want to go back in time. So it's actually about 10 years old.
Oh, wow.
It is the first virtual conference for Microsoft. We started it in 2010, and it had different names. It had MVC for ASP.NET MVC, which was the first open source thing that came out of Microsoft. Mm. Then was rebranded to ASP.conf for ASP.NET. And then they essentially got rebranded to .NET Conf. So I've been working with the foundation on .NET Conf for the past 5 or 6 years. So they're actually sponsored of the virtual conference.
Very nice.
But yeah.
So can you tell me about a little bit about your background with the .NET Foundation?
Right. Like I said, I've known a lot of the board members because I've been an MVP for the past 14 years. So when the foundation first started, I kind of just sort of stood back and kind of watched what it was going to do outside of just like, hey, an umbrella for projects and so forth. And it wasn't until I started working with the foundation with .NET Conf to say, oh, this is great. Now we can actually partner together because the goal is essentially for .NET Conf is to make .NET as attractive from the perspective of usability, portability, community base, as we can, and I'll showcase all the different projects that we have. So, and that is essentially what the kind of goes hand in hand with the mission of the foundation by trying to create, again, that hardness or that home for those projects along with the community around it.
Yeah.
So it's been a great partnership throughout several years. We actually have an event coming up next week. Actually, I think that's more of a Microsoft event, but we have a big event, our 10-year anniversary event coming in the fall. So we're looking forward to that. It's going to be awesome.
Very, very cool. So I think we hit on some, but the next question is, what are your contributions to the .NET Foundation and community?
So let's start with the community perspective, right? Many years ago, before I had kids, I had a lot more free time. Mm-hmm. So I actually worked on open source projects, right? So I created one project that sort of was popular. Because it essentially enabled some things that weren't out of the box with .NET. And the name of the project was called MVC Turbine. And essentially what it was, it's a little small component that you can put inside of ASP.NET that allow you to do dependency injection first, do these things with ASP.NET, make it more composable, be able to add services and do X and Y, which was fun because many years ago, around that same time, there was this big work with one ASP.NET, Scott Hanselman blogged about it for many years, which essentially was the foundation for .NET Core. So it was cool to sort of be back and be in the beginning and we start with a conversation with the product teams and saying, hey, here's why I did this. Here's where we're literally at this point where we are all trying to do the same thing. So we're parallel tracks. We just need to come to a head. Mm-hmm. Right. And then be able to enable for this platform. You know, people were saying, oh, .NET is not as attractive as Ruby and Rails back in 2008. or is not as awesome as Node or not as awesome as things. And the reason why that was is because it was more of like, well, great. Here are the features. It works. What else can we innovate on top of it? Mm-hmm. Right. So there was some churn in there that had to happen both internally at Microsoft and the community for us to go forward. So it was fun to be part of that, part of the community, again, providing an open source project and be able to be a voice for that, which obviously lent to my virtual conference work, which tied to doing more work with the foundation, doing those things. A fun thing that we do as part of the foundation as well, which myself and actually Scott Hanselman, who was working with me at the time still working with .NET Conf, obviously. But it was, we had a lot of different groups across the world saying, hey, we love .NET Conf. Can we borrow the brand? So the .NET Poland, .NET Conf Poland spun out of it, .NET Conf Japan. Mm. We actually, interestingly enough, borrowed the name from a conference in Russia called .NET Conf, but it was like, but they're in person as compared to us being virtual.
Right.
But anyway, but it's just interesting that everybody had the same idea. So it's like, great. And it was like, at this point is let us provide the platform and the value that it has. And then you guys take and run with it. We have zero say in how you should run it. Mm. You just borrow the name and you know, we're all on the same team here.
So speaking with these about these experiences that you have
right.
organizing and running conferences right. and then splitting off, what experiences do you have that will specifically lend a hand to being on the board?
That's great. So I do run my own consulting business, so I know about different operations. I am actually part of current boards, local boards to my hometown, where we have to, we're not for profit. So it's all about taking as much investment as we can in to invest back into the resources that we have. Like, for example, part of a baseball, a little league. So that takes a lot of money to run a baseball park, mm-hmm. right? And coaches and whatnot. So I have a lot of experience from that way. And the one thing I've learned from participating in this perspective, it's not about I have the right answer, right? It's mm-hmm. about a consensus. Mm-hmm. Right. So I've been on a board of 9 people, I've been on a board of 12 people. And really what it comes down to is more of like, okay, great. What is the goal that we're trying to achieve? I may be on someone's good side or on someone's bad side, depending on my stance.
Right.
But it's essentially is to say, hey, forget what you're trying to push and what is best for the organization. Mm-hmm. Right. You may not agree with it 100%. But you have to step back and be able to say, yeah, this makes sense. This, you know, by doing XYZ, the .NET community will become better. or we will provide for these things rather than saying, here's my seven step plan to better whatever, right? That doesn't stand. It's more of like, and now I have to sit there and be a representative for a greater good.
Mm. Very, very nice. So last question, what is your number one focus for the foundation?
My number one focus is to bring more of the, of that outsider perspective, right? Just because of, I've always played a back role on all of the things that I've done for the community. It's more of like, hey, here's what we have, but guess what? You know, there's people out there who are smarter than me and we should listen to them. Right. So I tend to be a voice of reason because I try to get as much knowledge from different people, trying to figure out, okay, is this the right approach? Is this not the right approach? So I hope to sort of, if elected, to be that, to play that same similar role, to saying, well, wait a minute, you know, history has taught us to be this, this, and this. And the reason why I say that is that I've been a .NET developer since 2001, 2002, since college. I'm old. So that's just the way it is. So I've seen the ups and downs of the community, of everything is that. So as compared to someone who's like, well, I've been doing .NET for 5 years. This is hot. This is great. It's like, great. But you have to understand that there are multiple facets. The community is not just one thing. It's different things. So how can you provide something for one aspect of the community and not alienate the other one and vice versa?
Wonderful answer. Well, I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for coming on to interview, Javier.
Yeah, thank you so much.
All right, thank you. Mm-hmm.